हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई आरती मैम वेलकम यू ऑल टू येट अनदर सेशन ऑफ इंग्लिश वर्कशीट नंबर 64 डेटेड 10 दिसंबर 2020। द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडेज वर्कशीट इज टेकन फ्रॉम फर्स्ट फ्लाइट चैप्टर 7 ग्लिम्स ऑफ इंडिया। दिस सेक्शन इज डिवाइडेड इंटू ग्लिम्स ऑफ इंडिया इज डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री पार्ट्स, दैट इज अ बेकर फ्रॉम गोवा, कॉर्ग एंड टी ऑफ असम। So we will be taking first chapter or first part of the series, that is Bakers from Goa. There is a comprehension passage that has been given, and after that certain questions are given. We have to do the questions according to the The loaves were bought by some Baskins and Bestin, the maid servants of the house. What we longed for were those bread bangles, which we chose carefully. Sometimes it was sweet bread of special make. The baker made his musical entry on the scene with the jang jang sound of his specially made bamboo staff. One hand supported the basket on his head, and the other banged the bamboo on the ground. He would greet the lady of the house with good morning and then place his basket on the vertical bamboo. We kids would be pushed aside with a mild rebuff, and the loaves would be delivered to the servant. But we would not give up. We would climb a bench or the parapet and peep into the basket somehow. I can still recall the typical fragrance of those loaves. Loaves for the elders and the bangles for the children. Then we did not even care to brush our teeth or wash our mouths properly. And why should we, who would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for the toothbrush? And why was it necessary at all? The tiger never brushes his teeth. Hot tea would wash and clean up everything so nicely after all. Now the question first is there. What pronounced or produces the jang jang sound? There are four options: bells on the bamboo pole, dragging of baker's basket, कॉइन्स इन द लेडीज पर्स एंड थर्ड ऑफ द स्टाफ। तो द आंसर वुड बी डी, द थर्ड ऑफ द स्टाफ। थर्ड मीन्स अ लाउड वॉइस दैट इज बीन मेड वेन समथिंग हैवी इज पुट ऑन द ग्राउंड और इज बैंगड ऑन द ग्राउंड। फाइन, सो इट वुड बी डी। मार्क एफ अगेंस्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर सेकेंड। मार्क एफ अगेंस्ट one statement, that is a fact. The children brought the loaves from the baker. No, it was a servant. See, it is the loaves were to be delivered to the servant. So this is a false statement. Hot tea was used to wash and clean at home. It is given that hot tea would wash and clean up everything so nicely. It was said for the children, so it may be a fact. The baker carried the basket on the head. Yes, it is written here. One hand supported the basket on the head, another this is a fact for sure. Sweet bread was made of bamboo mango leaves. No, it was a toothbrush that is made from mango leaves, so it is a false statement. This is not correct. So we can say against one statement, that is a fact. I think most probably the C part, this is the fact. So answer will be C, and their answer will be D. Okay, so let us come to question number third. Choose one meaning that corresponds is similar in meaning to the word used in passage. There are four words given. First is and second is rewind, C is reclaim, and D is revise. So the answer would be first, that is reprimand, that means rebuke or rebuke in a strong way. So this is given. Both of this means to deny something officially or formally. No, you can't get this. When we say formally, then it is called rebuke. Okay, now question number 4. Why did the children rush out when the bakers arrive at their house? Because they have agreed to feed themselves with loaves, with the bagels for the children. No? They were going to seek the bagels for themselves when the baker arrived at their house. They want the sweet bread, that is to be the fragrant loaves. No? See, here it is given. Ackle still recall the typical fragrance of the loaves for the elders and bangles for the children. This is the item which was seeked by children. So the children, whenever the baker come to their house, they rush to the to eat those loaves, and they even don't brush their teeth before eating that. Okay, question number 5. Describe the baker in your own words. You can write about the traditional dress, and you can give the appearance that he comes with the bamboo staff with him, and which was placed on the ground to create a jang jang sound. And so when you are telling about the baker, you can say they use they are more bakers, they use foreign Portuguese traditional furnaces, and the typical technique of making the loaves are same from the centuries. They are traditional, they wear khabai, and then you can describe about that also. The nature of the baker is to provide the food to all the people. They are humble, they are prosperous, and they are happy. It seems that a profession of baker is considered to be a happy profession or a prosperous profession. And if a person is a baker, he wouldn't starve for or his family wouldn't starve. These are the all things you can help to describe the baker, or you can also give an account of the coming of the baker to the village and distributing the loaves of bread. Okay, let us come to question number 6. We are given filling the blanks, and we have to fill them. Those eaters of loaves dash, but the makers are still there. Those eaters of loaves may have vanished. So it would be might have vanished. Okay, might have vanished, but the makers are still there. We still have amongst us the mixers, the molders, and those who bake the loaves. It would be second. This would be the second. Bake the loaves. LOAVES, loaves. Okay, the age-old time-tested furnaces still exist. The fire in the furnaces has not extinguished. So this will be has not yet been extinguished. Okay, I am writing this here. Extinguished. Okay. So this will be answer. So we can conclude that in first, second and third, the answer will be first, second and third. Okay, this was your worksheet. Hope you have understood it well.